I really do think a person should always be on their best behavior because you never know when you're going to make a new friend. Right, little guy? Bye. Bye, little guy. See you later. Hey, everyone. It's Zadira, and we're going to have a little bit of fun today. As you know, while we were building this flash rock base, we've been checking out these little goblins. So for days, I've been trying to find the Goblin Trading Center. I think it would be fun to maybe try doing that for a while and just see how many goblin bags we have to open before we get the trading center. I am so excited about this. We will go ahead and kill all but goblins, even though I think you're only supposed to be able to get the trading center from killing the Goblin King. But we'll open lots of bags and we'll see how much stuff we can get. Okay, let's see how many bags we have to open. Alright, we got a few Goblin Kings, but I'm not sure if they dropped bags or not. Let's see what we have here. Okay, there we go. That's wood. I think the plain goblins drop wood. And I think the bags look the same. So we must not. We only got wood. Oh, there's that Goblin King over there. Let's go get him really quick. The Goblin Kings are pretty vicious. They can hit you just with one whack and pretty much do you half health. Do your health halfway. Okay, that did not drop. Alright. Let's see. Here's one. I think getting them with these ghost dragons works extremely. Oh, there's another one down there. Let's see. Let's show you. There's a close up. It's on its side, though. Okay, so flint and certificates in that one. Let's get this little guy over here. They're so cute, but they are vicious. Did he leave? Yep, he left a bag. Let's try that one. And a gold ingot. Interesting. Well, you never can tell what you're going to find in a goblin bag. I think the rumor is that they steal from other people, but I'm not for sure certain in this game exactly where they get their items. All right, let's see here. Can we see any more? I'm pretty sure there's like this deep hole, or there's a plain goblin. He's always standing right there by the base, but at the end of this cavern, there's an interesting deep, deep hole. And every time I fly over here, a bunch just fall out of the sky. It's the most amazing thing. Let's see here. No, that's not the one. It's this one right here. Look at them. They fall out of the sky. So usually you can get three at a time. Let's get these guys. And there's one up there. You want to be sure. They'll hit you. They'll whack you really hard once, and then they'll take off running. But they can get my health down halfway. Okay, that one. Let's see, is he going to come down here as soon as I get off? Let's see what's in this bag. Another gold ingot. Interesting. All right, let's go up and get this guy. So the ghost dragons are pretty good at getting them. And yep, there was a bag. Did you see it? It was rolling down the hill. Let's go check that one out. But you can always have, I've seen five fall from the sky in this hole at a time, so that's amazing. Let's see here. And certificate. All right. So, all right, guys, I'm going to continue looking, and I will bring you back if we happen to find one. We'll see how long it takes. Guys, look, can you believe it? We finally got a Goblin Trading Center. We have been looking for these for days. It says, although you may be able to obtain some rare resources, it's not a good idea to trade with these goblins. Let's take this home and set it up. Awesome. All right, guys, I'll bring you back as soon as we get... Oop, there's another one underneath Spooky. Let me go check that one. Let's go take this home and set it up, but let's check. You never can tell. A primitive drill. Wow, that's one of the better things we got in these bags. Maybe we should go buy a lottery ticket. All right, let's take this home. I'll bring you right back as soon as we get over and get set up. I am so excited. I can't believe we actually got a Goblin Trading Center. I'm very curious to what they have to trade. The way I understand it is you can have different Goblin Trading Centers and they will trade different things in them. Oh, we can't place the structure. I wonder. I guess we'll have to put it on foundations maybe. Let's see. Is there enough down here? I had my DIY do-it-yourself hut here. Oh yeah, this will work. Except I think it's backwards, I believe. Let's see. Let's go. Yeah, I like that. Now let's put it so they aren't falling off of the platform. My goodness sakes alive. I have to be able to get to my little chest, too. So, maybe I could put it here and then extend out. I'll just fix some more foundations. It seems to want to sit here just fine. All right, guys, I'm sure curious. The way I understand is that different Goblin centers have different things to trade. So we'll see what ours has. Let me show you what it looks like. Oh, my goodness, isn't this awesome? Look at this. The detail. Oh, gosh. Look at all this. There's a magic lamp. I mean, oh, my goodness, and scrolls and jewels. They're just busy working. They have so much stuff they want to trade. Let's see how much what they actually have, though. All right, let's see here. Access inventory. All right, this is for red magic crystals, any magic stones. So if we put two magic stones, you know, for some reason I don't have any right now, but normally I have tons of those, but right now I don't, but we'll get some in a minute. And then sulfur for 5 bones, they'll give sulfur. Ooh, I know some people on our server, Bosco, that needs sulfur a lot. He's always looking for sulfur. He would be glad of that. And then here's white magic crystals. So any magic stone, and you can get white magic. We use a lot of these for healing essences, so that's really good because I get tons of those other stones that I don't use. And then silver. So that's interesting for 2. Quartz. I haven't found a need for quartz yet. I'm not sure what you use quartz for, but for 12 bones. And then blue magic stones for any magic stones. Blue is good because I use the water. Those are the water magic. I use those for slushy. He eats those. My refrigerator, he eats those. So I like to have lots of blue magic stones. And then the purple magic crystals. Down here is the mage weave bark for 9 wood, which we have a magic portal right here next to our house, so I have plenty of mage weave bark, so that won't be necessary. And then copper ore. Oh, I'm very disappointed because mainly what we're wanting the Goblin Trading Center for is we're wanting to be able to trade for sharp crystals. So I'm kind of disappointed, but yet I'm very happy about the sulfur and the white magic crystals because those are 2 things that we're going to be using a lot. So all in all, I'm very happy to have these guys, and definitely took a lot of work. Oh my goodness, that was a lot of work. It took quite a bit of time too. It was so much fun being able to work to get this. It's nice to have fun rewards for all your hard work, right? All right, that's it for this little episode. I appreciate each and every one of you so very, very much. I will see you next time. Bye.